बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, अस्सलाम वालेकुम एंड वेलकम टू फॉरवर्ड पब्लिक स्कूल ई लर्निंग क्लासेस, क्लास नाइन्थ, सब्जेक्ट इंग्लिश, टॉपिक सेफ्टी फर्स्ट, पार्ट टू, एंड आई एम योर इंग्लिश टीचर नाहिद अब्दुल्ला। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक इन पार्ट टू ऑफ यूनिट 11। वी डिड आवर रीडिंग एक्सप्लेनेशन अलॉन्ग विद डिफिकल्ट वर्ड्स मीनिंग्स इन पार्ट वन। Now we will do our book exercises. In this part, we will start from exercise B on page number 113, while part A you will find in your notes. Let's start with exercise B. Choose the correct answer for the following. Number 1. A burn should be immersed or placed under cold water for at least option A 5 minutes. Option B 10 minutes, option C 15 minutes, option D 20 minutes. So which one is the correct option? Option D 20 minutes. Number 2, if your friend cut his finger and it bleeds profusely, you should option A put the injured finger in some cold water, option B apply direct pressure over the wound, option C give him an aspirin, option D let him bleed till emergency doctor arrive. So option B is the correct one, apply direct pressure over the wound. Number 3, if one's nose bleeds, he should option A lie upside down, option B run towards home, option C give jerks to one's head, option D press his her nostrils in finger and thumb. So option D is correct, press his her nostrils in finger and thumb. Number 4. Which one of the following should be avoided if someone gets a heart attack? Option A. Call medical help as soon as possible. Option B. Ease the strain on the heart. Option C. Rest him her in half sitting position. Option D. Press his her chest. So which one is the correct? Option D. Press his her chest. Dear students, on page 114, under the title of writing, we have part C. Translate the following sentences from Urdu to English. Main pehle hi nokri ke liye darkhwast de chuki hoon. I have already applied for job. Mujhe kai roz se uska khat nahi mila hai. I have not received his letter for several days. Main apna kaam khatam kar chuka hoon. I have finished my work. Kya barish hone se pehle wo ghar aa gaya tha? Had he returned home before it rained? बागबान के आने से पहले लड़के फूल तोड़ चुके थे. The boys had plucked flowers before the gardener reached. मैं उसे 3 साल से जानता हूँ. I know him for 3 years. उसने मुझे धोखा दिया. He has cheated me. Dear students, open up page number 115. On page number 115, we have grammar. And in this grammar section, we will do punctuation exercises. Before starting with our exercises, let me introduce few punctuation marks to you, which will come in your exercises. Number 1 is full stop or periods. Periods or full stop ends the sentence. Number 2, question marks. They indicate the end of a sentence with a question. Next one is commas. They show a pause in a sentence. They can also combine two complete thoughts or sentences. They also separate items in the list. Colons. They link two independent clauses. Semicolon. They link two independent clauses in place of comma and are coordinating conjunctions. For example, and, but, or, nor, for, so, yet. Dear students, now let's start with our exercise. Number 1, choose the correct sentence. In all these 4 options, option B is correct. This is what I ate for breakfast, comma, an apple and a bowl of cereal. Number 2, choose the correct sentence. In all these 4 options, option B is correct. He knocked several times, semicolon, no one came to the door. Number 3, choose the correct sentence. In all these four options, option B is correct. My sister loves mysteries, comma, my brother likes comics. Number four, choose the correct sentence. In all these four options, option D is correct. Here is what you need to get at the supermarket, colon, bananas, comma, bread, comma, milk and biscuits. On page 116, we have sentence number five. And in all these four options, option B is correct. The window was open, comma, I looked out over the empty fields. Now we will do exercise. Throughout the following paragraph, you will find a number of empty paired brackets. Replace each set of brackets with a comma or semicolon. The title is pasta. Pasta. Pasta, comma, a large family of shaped, comma, dried wheat paste, comma, is a basic staple in many countries. Its origins are obscure. Rice paste were known very early in China, semicolon. Pastes made of wheat were used in India and Arabia long before they were introduced into Europe in the 11th or 12th century. According to legend, comma, Marco Polo brought a pasta recipe with him from Asia in 1295. Pasta quickly became a major element in the Italian diet, semicolon, and its use spread throughout Europe, full stop. Pasta is made from durum wheat flour, comma, which makes a strong, comma, elastic dough. Hard durum wheat has the highest wheat protein value. The flour is mixed with water, comma, kneaded to form a thick paste, semicolon, and then forced through perforated plates or dies that shape it into one of more than 100 different forms. The students, on page 116, we have our last exercise about punctuation marks and capital letters, where we use capital letters when we start a sentence. Rewrite the following sentences using appropriate punctuation marks and capital letters wherever necessary. Number one, River Ravi flows through Lahore. This small r will be replaced by capital R since the sentence starts with this. Ravi. Ravi is the name of the river. It will be replaced by capital R. And this small l will be replaced by capital L. Number two, Eiffel Tower is the most famous monument in France. This small e of Eiffel will be replaced by capital E, and this small f will be replaced by capital F. Number three, my brother is a singer. Since this is the start of the sentence, we will replace this small m by the capital M. My brother is a singer. Number four, where have you been all this while? This is a question mark. First of all, we will put question mark at the end of the sentence. And the sentence starts with capital letter, so small w will be removed and capital W will be put here. Number five, you look hot, are you ill? You, it is starting the sentence, so Y will be replaced by capital Y. And after hot, we have comma and then question mark at the end of the sentence. Number six, come here at once, come. This is starting the sentence. C will be replaced by capital C, and we will put full stop or period at the end of the sentence. Number seven, Abrar is a smart boy. Abrar is the noun, is the name of a person. It will start with capital A, and we will put full stop at the end of the sentence. Number eight, Sanya couldn't believe her eyes when she saw the bicycle. So Sanya is the name, it's the noun, and it's the beginning of the sentence also. So we will replace the small s by capital S. And after bicycle, we will put full stop or period. Number nine, India is the seventh largest country in the world. India, I will be replaced by capital I, and we will put full stop or period at the end of the sentence. Number 10, Karachi is the capital of Sindh, Karachi. K will be replaced by capital K, and Sindh S will be replaced by capital S, and we will put full stop or period at the end of the sentence. Dear students, With this, we come to the end of final part, that is part 2 of Unit 11. Hope you will find it useful. Thank you. Keep learning. Stay safe. Stay healthy.